Hey guys, we're Evan and Katelyn, and today we're gonna cut aluminum on our carby for the first time.
All I need to do is press this button. So instead of just carving anything, we wanted to try carving something useful and something where accuracy is important. So we're gonna make this little square right here. It's gonna be really tiny, but we'll be able to test the accuracy, which is important.
I just have a gut feeling that it's not gonna work the first time.
But we've done enough research and talked with enough really smart people to know that something will happen. And it's possible, it's totally possible. I have faith that it's possible.
It's not gonna work the first time. Something will happen.
That didn't really go as planned.
No. It seemed like it was trying to go too deep too fast.
Yep, and that downward force combined with the rotation of the bit caused it to walk all over the place. Luckily, the carvy shut it down.
Yeah, so I might have had the settings a little bit too aggressive.
Really?
I increased the amount of plunge, I reduced the...
Wait, we increased the plunge?
Yeah, so the plunge is how much it slowly leads in.
Oh.
So I increased the plunge, I decreased speeds, and just made everything a little bit more gentle.
Let's try this again.
You can do it, little guy.
I believe in you!
Oh! I don't know, that didn't seem right. It seemed to kick back a little bit. Yeah.
Still a little kick.
I'll tweak a few more things. One of the things that's gonna allow us to carve aluminum pretty fast and get a really accurate finish are the advanced tool paths that you have access to in Fusion 360. We are going to be doing an adaptive pass, which takes away a majority of the material, the 2D pocket hole, which is gonna allow us to remove material that's inside of our part. And we are gonna do two contour passes, one to clean up an edge and one that'll cut the whole part out.
Is it supposed to be on air?
Yeah. Because I already cut out that.
Oh, yeah. It is less rattly. The googly eye is not rattling this time.
Yeah.
That was terrible.
In general, you can cut faster with adaptive clearing because it cuts with a fraction of the bit instead of plowing straight through the material with 50% of the bit loaded with the cut. Ooh, adaptive clearing success. It took 3 tries, but the great thing about the carvy is everything was enclosed. It was a little bit scary, but I wasn't that scared.
So what's next?
So now that we have this, you know what? I'm gonna open this up, vacuum this up, and show you what we have so far. The surface finish, it's pretty good. It looks like there's ridges, but here, feel that.
Oh yeah, it's very subtle. It looks like it's way more than it is.
So the adaptive clearing pass is done, and that gave us this little ridge right here. Now we're gonna put some holes in there just so I can test pocket holing.
Too aggressive. Seems to be the theme.
Have my finger on the pause button.
Just in case. No, it's okay. I think it's okay.
Right.
That's weird that it's a trouble spot right there in the middle. Right there.
I think it's when it's plunging.
Running it.
first one went okay. How confident are you about the second one, though?
I'm pretty confident about the second one.
All right, cool.
Oh, one more operation. Just gotta cut out the outside.
It's so shiny.
Shiny!
Shiny! Since this 3D adaptive toolpath created this surface in a series of nibbled passes, this was never fully straightened and cleaned up. So, before we do the outside contour path, we're gonna do a few skim passes along that edge to straighten things out.
Put them there.
Bring them in line. There's a little bit of cleaning.
That's pretty conservative.
Hey, do you blame me at this point?
No.
But this is what I want. Like, it was an okay edge. Now I'm just making it, like, clean. This is actually just what I want.
What were you saying?
That's just what I wanted! So I went a little bit deeper than I expected.
Oops.
It actually worked out okay, though. In the end?
Well, we're not to the end yet. Okay, so now we're gonna do the final outline.
Yeah, and I have two ideas on this. One, we can leave tabs.
Yes. I mean, we'll have to clean them up later.
Or we can use these pockets that we milled out and screw them into the wasteboard with those pockets.
Oh! We're gonna have to be careful though, because this hole in particular is really close to this edge. And if there's any jitter, we don't want it banging the end of the screw. There it goes.
Moment of truth. This is when it's plunging in. Think it's okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Or do I need to slow down?
No, it needs to be slowed down.
Okay.
Too much. Bring it down a little bit.
You can see where it started skipping there, especially. And keep going.
This is the finishing pass.
So we're doing okay.
Maybe a little rough coming in here. Alright, I have good news and I have bad news. Good news is check out the CNC. Look at that! It's so beautiful!
Yeah. Bad news.
I didn't catch it on the camera cutting through at the end.
You kind of worried me.
I know. That's why I wanted to worry you. So then me not capturing this would be okay.
Are you ready?
So ready!
Oh my gosh, it's so cute.
That is awesome.
So cute and so sharp.
Yeah, careful with those. We'll deburr it.
Time to clean it up.
But actually, it's also midnight, so...
Time to go to bed.
Time to go to bed, and tomorrow we will clean this up, inspect it closely.
And put it to the test. It is time. Time for what, you might ask?
Finishing the piece?
Alrighty, everything's filed and cleaned up. Now it's time to test our homemade square against a machinist square, the most accurate one that we own. Let's see how they compare. What do you think?
I think it is gonna be really, really square, yet there are a little imperfections in here. So that's a long way of saying, yes, I'm very confident. What about you?
I think there's gonna be little gaps and kind of imperfections where it's not fully butted up against the material, but I think overall it will be a right angle and it will be straight. Shall we test it?
Let's toss it. Da, 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 da. Oh, wow.
What? There's not even any gaps.
That's better than I thought.
What? I thought we tore it up more than that. That's actually really good.
Ah. All right, so now that we've tested the outside, let's test the inside. I don't see any gap. Wow. Okay, yeah. Let's use it to like check things. I just like having a tiny square in general. A good use for this is checking to see if your tools are still square, such as this chisel. And, oh man, that's interesting. There's a dent in the chisel and I didn't see it until I put it up against here. The dent is right there.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's crazy.
So our square is awesome, but our chisels are crap.
No, that's on us too. We were probably abusing them a little bit much. True. Guys, I'm just so excited that we can machine aluminum in our garage accurately.
We can make so many parts now.
We can make machines, gears.
Build our own robots.
Build our own robots. Thank you guys for tuning in and watching another one of our videos, and look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.
Approval? It's fully absorbed now.
We're never gonna get it back.